Good evening. Welcome to MILTALK. MILTALK is a new program that's designed to inform the public about various activities the Navy's involved in the Pensacola area complex. It's also designed to give information about activities and programs to military retirees, veterans, active duty, their families and dependents, about things like that. So if you have any questions about that, please give us a call. Our topic tonight is going to be Ombudsman. And with us tonight, we have some special guests I'd like to introduce. On my left here, we have the Ombudsman Coordinator for Pensacola Complex, Mrs. Pat Murphy. Next to her, we have one of the Ombudsmen off the USS Lexington, Mrs. Diane Granger. And next to her, we have the Ombudsman for the Naval Hospital, and that's Mrs. Trudy, Campbell. And we also have a special guest, Mr. Kevin Holloway, who's the President of Combined Talent.
Your car.
Yeah, well, it's happy.
An ombudsman is a spouse of an active duty service member who represents the command as far as the dependents. Someone that can guide her into a real positive direction for their stay at any particular duty station.
How long has the Ombudsman program been in effect?
The program was established in September 1970. As the years have gone by, they have revised it, updated it through checking and doing surveys with each and every ombudsman.
You're also involved in the Ombudsman Academy, which is kind of something that teaches people how to become an ombudsman and what to do in their commands?
Yes, we have two ombudsman training academies a year. One is in the winter and one is in the spring. The winter month consists of right around September, and spring is right around March. The training consists of all types. It goes from drug and alcohol, child abuse, alcohol abuse, spouse abuse, body language, active listening, learning what you need to know for Navy Relief, for Red Cross. We just take in a wide scope and a wide area. And part of the area is also knowing our community resources that we can reach out for advice and help from.
Okay, we have our first call in here. Welcome to MILTALK.
Yes, I got two corrections to make. I thought it was Butch Wallace, not Botch Wallace. They got on the front as B-O-T-C-H.
How you doing, Doc Corey?
He's a Butch. And he's not a Master Chief, he's a Mr. Chief. And he looks so damn silly up there out of uniform. Get back in the group.
That's Doc Corey from Handicaps USA, one of the fantastic organizations I had the opportunity of working with when I was Command Master Chief there at Corey Station. He just finished a Handicaps USA banquet at the Hilton. It's a fantastic organization. Thanks a lot, Doc.
You're welcome, Butch.
What a way to kick it off.
Well, let's see. How often are you on call for Ombudsman, Diana?
24 hours a day.
7 days a week?
7 days a week.
And how much do you get paid for this type of job, Trudy?
Nothing. It's just volunteer work.
You know, yesterday we were talking. It's something that astonished me. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, no pay. Why? You must really love it.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good question. Why did you get into the Ombudsman program, Pat?
I want to be active. I'm a very active person. I want to be helpful. I want to know what is going on. I want to meet not only the people in the community, but also the fellow service members. Each active duty service member tours around, he has a family, and each family will meet a different family. That's a way of learning new and different cultures, learning each person's background, where they come from, and it's interesting.
How about yourself, Diana? Why did you get into the program?
I like being informed. I like knowing what's going on. We're stationed here for the next 3 years, and I'm a people person. I love to meet people, and I just feel like I like to help people a lot.
And Trudy?
I was kind of pushed into the situation, to tell you the truth. I didn't know what an ombudsman was. But I thought it was great when I found out what it was. I said, I can't believe they had this all this time. All this time we've been in the service, they had this, and I didn't know it. I said, I'll go for it. You know, I'll help people. I like that.
I've been as the ombudsman for the Naval Hospital. You get some calls that try and usurp the appointment system over there and trying to use in your influence to try and get some appointments. Is that true?
Yes, but that's not my job. You know, I wouldn't do that, you know. Wait your turn like everybody else, you know. I'm a good listener, and you know, you always have people ready to tell you what to do, advise you, you know, you ought to do this. Just ask anybody, you know. They'll be ready to tell you. But it's very seldom you find a good listener. You
know? That's very true. Very
yeah.
true. Now, Diana, you're the only ombudsman of a deployed command here. Everybody else has got shore commands. You've got to have some unique problems that you're involved in as far as deployed commands are concerned. What are some of those things that might be unique to the USS Lexington?
One of the unique problems is when the ship is gone, we deal a lot with Red Cross. We, when people call in and they call Red Cross and they have a problem, Red Cross contacts the ship and then calls the people back and verifies, you know, that the message was sent. A lot of times the ship doesn't call the Red Cross to let us know what was going on, if the spouse will be shipped home or not. So then we get the call, and we have to handle it like that, and we contact the COD shack, which contacts the ship, and then they contact us back, telling us if the person will be able to come home or not.
I guess you have to deal with the Red Cross and get a lot of some money as far as getting some of these people back also. That's probably another part of that problem that exists.
Yes, it does.
Does the ombudsman work with the civilian sector also, pertaining to the Lexington at all?
The Red Cross sector?
Well, you yourself, working with the community to, I don't know if you wanted to say promote the Lexington or just inform the people on what the Lexington's doing in and out when it comes back in or not.
No, I have not, personally.
All the facilities in the local area are available for her use, but if she doesn't have to go outside the channels, she can use the Naval Hospital and things mm-hmm. like that. You always stay within that, but she's also welcome to use the HRS and any system like that that's available to her also.
Okay, great.
And Trudy, there's got to be times when your talents as an ombudsman are needed more often than not over there at the Naval Hospital. When are those times?
I'd say when new people come in, you know, I'd like to let them know that I am there, you know, even if it's just a shoulder to cry on, more or less, because you know these young people, they come into the service and they move to a strange place, they don't know nobody, you know, and it gets kind of hectic at times, you know, staying in the same place, you know, just somebody to talk to if they need.
How about sometimes don't you deploy surgical teams out of the Naval Hospital and end up with a lot of spouses here without their military members?
Yes, that's the most time I'm needed, I believe, you know. I'm there if they need me, they can call me and I can help them out.
And Pat, you, in order to keep everybody informed of what's going on as far as activities, do you you have some type of seminars or things scheduled that you do for the ombudsman in the local area?
The ombudsman in the Pensacola area meet once a month, and that's usually the first Wednesday of every month. We discuss some of the hard-pressed problems that maybe one ombudsman is experiencing to get some feedback on how that particular problem was handled, what area and what direction that she went into to get the help needed. The ombudsman also attend various types of meetings, the commissary meetings, the Navy Exchange meetings for MWR, which is Morale, Welfare, and Recreation. And then we also have the quarterly meetings that they attend, where if one problem isn't solved on the lowest level possible, then we have an opportunity quarterly to take that problem to higher ranks.
Okay. Diana, you must meet with the commanding officer occasionally and also maybe the command master chief. What type of things do you discuss when you have a meeting with the commanding officer?
Usually difficult calls we handle. We tell the Command Master Chief, well, usually he already knows about them because we've discussed them with him earlier, but he makes the captain aware of them, and we talk about a different way maybe we could handle the problem, you know, or a better way.
Okay. We have another call here. Good evening. Welcome to MILTALK.
Thank you. With an ombudsman, when there is an abuse case that might be turned in, how does the family advocacy program at the hospital work in with that?
They're assigned to a social worker, and they go from there.
The family advocacy problems that we have, it depends what type they are, and sometimes they get pretty hectic. The Naval Hospital is, Naval Hospital is really good in helping us out, but also there's other activities in the local area that you have to deal with, too, on some of those family advocacy problems, aren't there?
Depending on the problem, usually the call will come from the spouse. If the trouble is really bad, will come from the spouse to the Master Chief of the command. The Master Chief will direct that problem to the Ombudsman. We check the spouse that's calling, go over, see the, what condition, what kind of, exactly what kind of help she needs, advise her on what she can and cannot do. We cannot tell her and we cannot force her to do anything.
That's true. However, if it ever gets to the family advocacy in the Naval Hospital, there are two members there that are dedicated for this type of things, and they can actually make a military member come in for counseling, and the military member is obligated to go through a full counseling phase with the Naval Hospital representatives there in order to try and settle this matter and to get the people back together and to settle the problem. And thank you very much for the question. How about yourself? I imagine that you meet with your command master chief occasionally. Mm-hmm. Master Chief Link was there.
Yeah, I ask for a lot of advice because I'm fairly new in this too, you know, and I don't want to do anything that I shouldn't. But he's very good. He really is. He's out there trying to help me, you know. Anything I need, he's there for me.
Okay. Let's take a short break here, and we'll be back with you shortly.
The offer from Sandy Sansing Chevrolet. No cash down payment for qualified buyers, just affordable monthly payments. Chevy S10 pickups, $150.98 per month. 60 months at 11.5 APR, sale price $62.88 after rebate. Chevy S10 Blazers, $226.48 per month. 60 months at 11.5 APR, sale price $94.95 after rebate. Payments based on delivered drive-out prices at Sandy Sansing Chevrolet in Car City, Pensacola. Don't look for hidden charges because there are none.
Hello, I'm Bob Grissom.
And I'm David Riddle. Each week we'll be your host on CNB Scene, a show sponsored by Citizens and Builders Federal Savings Bank.
Each Tuesday at 6:30, you'll have the opportunity to call and talk to our guests about changes taking place in Pensacola and innovations in the banking world.
So we invite you to make sure you're here each Tuesday at 6:30. We'll be waiting on your call.
Today is my 65th birthday. Now I need a doctor who will accept Medicare assignment. OnCall helped me locate him.
You know, we're at an age now where yearly checkups are very important, especially for cancer. So I contacted OnCall. They've already directed me to a physician.
My family means everything to me. That's why when we moved here, I contacted OnCall.
For years, Mr. Davis has depended on me. Recently, he was showing signs of stress, so I contacted OnCall.
All the care you need.
Hi, I'm Larry Fordham with Fordham Insurance. Please join me and my exciting guest Monday night at 8:30 for Health Insurance Line right here on Blab TV. Remember now, get your health insurance questions ready and call in. That's Health Insurance Line Monday night at 8:30 right here on Blab TV. See you Monday.
The offer from Sandy Sansing Chevrolet. No cash down payment for qualified buyers, just affordable monthly payments. Chevy Camaro RS, $266.36 per month. 60 months at 11.5 APR, sale price $11,195 after rebate. Chevy Celebrity, $238.21 per month. 60 months at 11.5 APR, sale price $99.95 after rebate. Payments based on delivered drive-out prices at Sandy Sansing Chevrolet in Car City, Pensacola. Don't look for hidden charges because there are none.
Welcome back to Mill Talk. Our subject tonight is Ombudsman, and we'll start this second half off with a call-in. Good evening. Welcome to Mill Talk.
Yes, sir. I was wondering, I understand the gentleman there to your right with combined talents?
Combined talents.
Yeah. I was wondering what kind of activities they have going on base there.
At the present time, right now, what we're doing... Hello? At the present time, right now, we are working very tightly with the military to hopefully work very closely with the military to next year. We're working with the NCOA, the Vietnam vets, and hopefully the military to put on a major function to provide an R&R for the Vietnam vets next year on April 8th and 9th. Very successful, we're hoping.
Major thing is we're going to try and gain some new socks from.
Yes, I'm a complete ridicule on that all the time. But that's all right. I'm becoming a trendoid.
I'd like to also add that the Non-Commissioned Officers Association is sponsoring Mill Talk, and they've been fantastic. They did this on the air, and I think it can be really successful. So I encourage anybody out there that's got any questions or anything, please call in. We've got enough expertise here. Hopefully we can answer your question. If not, we can get your name and get back to you later. By the way, y'all all have to be married in order to be an ombudsman, that's for sure. How do your husbands, I know they have to help out in a lot of these ombudsman problems, too. Do they kind of give you a hard time in executing some of their share of the responsibility, Trudy?
No, like I said, if I need anything, and he kind of gets on the lady side of it, I just talk to the master chief, and he helps me.
Talk to the man master chief,
yeah,
and your husband
done.
Decides that he'll help out, huh?
Yeah.
That's the way it's good. It's a good
yeah.
way to do it. How about you, Diane? Does your husband help out?
Oh, yeah. Well, sometimes when I get a call and he's so tired of it, sometimes he'll hand me the phone and he'll say, "It's for you, Diana, again." So, but he's real helpful. He's real understanding.
I think it takes two, because if they didn't want you to be in that position, you know, it would be very hard for you to do your duties.
Oh, yeah.
How about you, Pat?
My husband was very excited when I decided to take the ombudsman job. It took me a long time to make the decision. After I made the decision and he started seeing the amount of work that had to be put into it, one of that was writing a monthly newsletter. And when you have 1,000 newsletters that you have to prepare for the mail system, you need help. And I asked him to help me, and he says, "No, I didn't volunteer for this." And I said, "Well, you know, there is a Navy instruction that says you have to help." And he says, "No, I don't." And I said, "Well, I believe I need to make a call to the Command Master Chief." And at that time, you were my Command Master Chief, helping out and advising me. And he says, "This is not fair."
You're trying to say he ultimately ended up licking and stamping and
oh yes, oh. And enjoyed every second of it.
I'm sure.
Very is that a big requirement? Grin on his face.
Is that a requirement? Does that state that they have to help you out, or?
Yes, that is in the instruction and also in the ombudsman handbook, that the spouse have to be very supportive, because there is a tremendous amount of time and effort, and there has to be understanding that also goes along with the work.
Do y'all have any problems with your husbands helping you out?
Let's take a break, okay? We have another phone. Welcome to Mill Talk.
Yes, sir. I was wondering, when is the Elvis Presley imitators will be on base? Thank you.
Elvis Presley imitators are going to be on base. Caught me. They're probably there tonight. Who knows?
I'm sorry. I don't have that information, and even didn't even know that was going to happen. Anybody hear about
I
that?
I haven't.
That's something we can remember for next week. Heartbreak Hotel opened, though, today. That's supposed to be something to it. You know what I need to do? I need to tell everybody to, in the civilian area, to call in, because there's only a number of questions that I can ask for the civilian community. So please help me out. These ladies here have just ample information to give out, and I can only ask so much besides look at them and enjoy.
We have another phone call here. Good evening. Welcome to MILTALK.
Yes, I'd like to ask Pat a question. The ombudsman, when they do their job, it's a highly confidential matter. Can you expand more on that?
Yes, I would be more than glad to. Along with being an ombudsman, there is a code that you also have to abide by, and that is the one of confidentiality. What a dependent, any dependent or any spouse confides in you, you cannot repeat this. You can advise that person where they can go and reach out for help, the professional help that is needed. Ombudsmen are also known as paraprofessionals because we do work closely with the counselors. However, I feel a need to stress that if a dependent or a spouse, anyone that is attached with the military, they tell an ombudsman something that is illegal, robbing or stealing or even thinking of committing suicide, that has to be reported to the proper authorities. The ombudsman used the chaplain very much in a situation like this, and the chaplain decides which direction then it should go. But that is very important for everyone to understand that we do honor that, and we do not take lightly any disclosure that is not reasonable.
That's true. You have to work with the chaplains, and they're the ones that can really tell you whether something, through common sense, that there's going to be an emergency there, that you need to bring that to somebody's attention, because we definitely don't want to lose a life or something like that because of some confidentiality factor. But at the same time, everything is said to you is kept in confidence. That's great. There's got to be some unique problems that you have as an ombudsman that you might... I know when I was as command master chief, I used to kind of give certain problems. Like I knew I had one a kid that was having a hard time getting through school, and it's because his spouse was giving the individual a hard time because they just gotten married, and so he had the pressures of the school and the marriage on him. And I had to use an ombudsman to go out to actually talk to the military spouse to the spouse of the military member to try and get him on our side. And do y'all have some kind of unique experiences like that that you'd like to go over with?
I can relate to one, or maybe even possibly several, young wives in a relationship. They're fresh away from home. Say they're 20 years old, their husband is 20 years old. They're in a completely new environment, a new culture. Their husband is not home. He is out at the base, doing God knows whatever, you know, what those military people do.
Oh, God.
And then all of a sudden, the wife is being told, or the spouse, the husband, whichever the case is, that I have to stay after and study. Now, the wife just does not believe this, and she finds it a real difficulty. My husband is in school all day. He's studying, so he says, and now he has to stay after school to study, and we have problems getting them to understand that.
We have a phone line. Good evening. Welcome to MILTALK. Hello?
Yes. Do you plan on having concerts for, like, younger children? Early teenagers that they can participate in?
Oh, are we talking about on the bases themselves?
On the bases.
Again, would y'all have any information on any of that?
I don't.
No, the...
Maybe she's talking like maybe a possible...
Well, some youth, you know, entertainment for the youth, you know, type things like that.
Young children. Maybe if the family is there, they leave the base, like a nursery type. Mm-hmm. I'm sure the MWR department might have something like that in process. CNET, I know, is working putting some ideas together right now for some major shows in some of the different bases.
Well, we're going to have to close out our first session of Mill Talk. I sure appreciate all the people that did call in. I want to thank you very much, and also remind you that the Non-Commissioned Officers Association did sponsor us. Kevin, is anything you'd like to say?
Again, I'd like to thank everyone here. Again, the NCOA has been very helpful. Another gentleman by the name of Mr. Bob Smith made a lot of this possible tonight. I'd like to personally thank him also.
And I thank you ladies for appearing on the show, taking time out. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay. Next week.